Hi guys, I'm Josh and you're watching my DIY channel video Epo, and in this video I'm going to make a steel tongue drum and I'm going to use deep frying pans, the kitchen kadai. You might have noticed this kind of kadai being used in the fast food or the street food shops here in India, especially here in Chennai. There are professional methods to make steel pans, but mine is a DIY version. And believe me, the results are really good. In case if you want to make one, I am sure this video will be of some help. And even otherwise, you can watch this video for who makes a musical instrument out of a kitchen kadai every day. Let the fun begin. About 4 years ago, I was browsing and searching for music instruments that made unique sounds. And I came across instruments like kalimba, didgeridoo, ocarina, music instruments that were made out of PVC pipe and a lot more. So far on my channel, I've attempted to make a kalimba, I've made an ocarina, I've made pan flutes, I've made PVC flutes and a cajon. In case you're interested in watching those videos, the links are given in the description below. I also came across this unique instrument called as hangpan, and I had no clue on how this was made, but it sounded really superb. There were other similar instruments like steel tank drum or tongue drum. They sounded very similar. Now these genre of instruments have different brand names, but the concept and the sound is really similar. I came across this video called How to Make a Tank Drum by this channel called Frontierless Craftsman. He uses a gas tank to make a tank drum. I followed his tutorial, but instead of the gas tank, I've used an alternative. I was looking for some options. I was in a fast food shop where the apple fell on my head. This frying pan is made out of iron, and if I tap it in the center, it has a certain frequency to it. This deep frying pan is about 1 millimeter in thickness, and by welding two of them together, I could achieve the same effect or at least get a shape similar to that of the steel pans. Will this work? I'm not sure, but like I always say, trying is an option I cannot ignore.
So I'm going to use my Dremel tool to cut these bits off and take these handles off.
There are frying pans without these handles, but unfortunately it was not available and the available ones were too thick for this project. With the handles out of the way, it leaves behind the rivet holes which will be welded later.
One thing promising at this point of time is the shape of it. It looks like a pan, hang pan, right? So that is one good thing that is happening right now.
The frying pans have a layer of oil to avoid rusting and thus needs cleaning. It was wiped with a generous amount of turpentine. Both the pans are identical, so I picked one for the top half where the tongues will be cut out. Then I placed a cutting mat on the table simply because the markings on the cutting mat makes the measurements a lot easier. The pan was flipped and I tried to figure out the center using a bendable ruler and some basic geometry. The goal here is to mark the surface into 8 equal parts, which I think doesn't need much of an explanation. Once the marks were made, at this point I took a wild guess on the size of the tongues to be made on this pan. The cutting wheel was switched to the one with a smaller diameter so that the slit is just enough for the jigsaw blade to pass through. Then I inserted the jigsaw and I cut through the pan following the marks I had made. There is no template or measurements for whatever I am doing here. It is trial and error. The jigsaw blades leave a serrated burr which can hurt if not cleaned. It's important to sand it down before tapping on it, even to check the tune or the sound.
To give you a quick update,
what I saw here was, in order to make the higher notes, the tongues have to be even thinner. The jigsaw blade is too wide for this task, so I chose to reduce the size of the blade itself. This is not the right way to grind the blade, or any blade for that matter. I am showing you the process. Later, I wore the gloves and I followed all the safety procedures. Here is a quick comparison of before and after the grinding. The width of the blade is cut by half, and I hope now it works in our favor. To appease my curiosity, I kept checking on the sound quality now and then. Actually, making the tongue is not very difficult, but getting it sound right is going to be a huge challenge. Seems like my guessing has gone wrong in a few places. The length and the size of the tongue has to be reduced, for which I need to weld it. After a few trial runs, I started welding the workpiece. I am sure you will not like what you see next. Welded some places and burnt a hole through my workpiece in a lot of places. I am showing you my mistake because please use MIG welding or gas welding. If you can't do it, take help from the professionals. It will save you a valuable time and of course your money as well.
This is not a welding DIY by the way, but I'm just sharing what I've done. So I ran a bead on top of it. It was okay. But when I tried doing that on the cut marks, trying to fill in these gaps, it was blowing holes. I have no clue how to fix that. So I have no other option but to work with the other piece that I have and then find a suitable piece for the bottom.
Back to square one. I did the process all over again. Using cutting wheels on angle grinder was resulting in longer unintended slits, and my welding skills aren't nice either. So now for this part, I ordered some cutting disc for the Dremel. This has a diameter of 38mm. The slit it makes should be barely enough for the jigsaw blade to go through. Also, I'm going to use this extension cable for the Dremel for better stability. Before working on the new workpiece, I tried it on the discarded one, and this plan seems to work. Once the cut was made, I inserted a jigsaw blade to make sure it will fit in, and it does. I began making the cuts and it worked. The tuning process is quite intuitive. No matter even if I used a tuning app, I wasn't getting it right and I had to rely on my ears and my basic music skills. I would check a note and that would progress a millimeter and then check it again. And I kept repeating the process until I was okay with whatever I was doing. I'm not sure if this is the right thing to do, but I took a butane torch and heated the metal till it turned blue. Once the metal started becoming red hot, I took it out and I quenched it in cold water. It was time to put the two halves together, but I was sure it will not be me who is going to do the welding. I took it out to a gas welding shop where this elderly person took patience to listen to my need and welded it for me. All this heat throws the tuning away and it had to be redone. So this is how it sounds like now. For the final part, the welding seams were sanded and I gave it a coat of black spray paint to cover up the welding seams and the scratch marks. After giving it a touch of paint, this is how it looks like and this is how it sounds like. Now this top part here had a tongue, but I had to remove it because it was way out of tune. So instead of making the hole in the bottom, I made the hole on top. Now this design looks very much like the idiopans, and there is one added feature of the idiopans. You can attach magnets underneath the tongues and adjust the tune according to the scale that you are playing. Now this is a steel pan that I have made. It's not very professional, but it sounds really cool. I like it and it makes me happy, and that's all that matters to me right now. Guys, I hope you like this video, and if you do, please do share it with your friends. Guys, you know that I take a lot of efforts in making these videos, and I would really appreciate if you could subscribe to my channel and share my videos as much as you can. I'll be back with another interesting video very soon. Until then, bye.